Sharia law in a nutshell, it means a guidance. It's a how-to manual that God has given to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So Sharia law is a guidance. It's a how-to manual. You know, when we go and take a driving test, it's a how-to manual for how to drive. When we go to schools and colleges, you have how-to manual for the students. When you go to a new place of work, we have a how-to manual for the employees. So Sharia law is a how-to manual of how we as human beings should live, as individually and as society. Now, if I ask you this question, the thing that comes to your mind when you hear the word Sharia law? Just be honest, right? Just speak your heart.
Oppression?
Oppression and what else?
Caliphate,
and how about this, and how about that, right? So, the very first thing that comes to the mind is the punishment system, right? Cutting, chopping, things of that nature. So let me just give an analogy to all of you. Suppose if people from Mars, if they come and they ask me the question, you know, Brother Sabil, what is the US Constitution about? If I tell them that the US Constitution is, it kills people, that's all I say, and then they leave. Have I done justice to the US Constitution?
No.
No, I have not. Come on, I have not, right? I have left out the breadth and the beauty of the US Constitution. The benefits it provides to the people, the equality it speaks about, the services it provides to the young and the old. I have left out the breadth and the beauty of the US Constitution. Even though what I mentioned, it was like 0.5% of what US Constitution is about. In the same way, under the breadth and the beauty and the umbrella of the Sharia law, the punishment system is less than 0.5%. Means every society, we need to have the checks and balances. Right? We have the police force, we have the armed forces, that there should be checks and balances. So in the same way, under the Sharia law of the Qur'an, there are no less than 15 passages that speaks about the punishment system. The rest of the 6 days, it speaks about how can we peacefully connect with God, that is part of the Sharia law. Honoring our parents, that's part of the Sharia law. Having mercy to the young and respecting the older people, that's part of the Sharia law. Giving charity is part of the Sharia law. Me smiling at you is part of it. We are connecting with you, you having lunch, you're listening over here, you're educating, that's part of the Sharia law. So Sharia law is God's guidance that God has given to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Now Sharia law given to Muhammad, peace be upon him, is not the only Sharia law. Sharia law or God's guidance was also given to the previous prophets and the messengers. For example, the Ten Commandments which are there in the Old Testament, Exodus chapter 20, it speaks about the guidance given to the Jewish people, and we say that that was the Sharia law given to Prophet Moses and his people. When Prophet Jesus, when he came and he said that I came not to destroy the law or the prophets, I came to fulfill. Matthew chapter 5 verse number 17. We say that Jesus came to fulfill and to approve the Sharia law given to Prophet Moses, peace be upon him. So Sharia law in a nutshell, it is God's guidance of how we can live as individuals, peacefully, proactively, engaging and enhancing the society. When we speak about equality in the Constitution, that all people are equal, all races are equal, that's what the Sharia law preaches. It says in the Quran, chapter number, it says, actually Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he mentioned, that all humanity, an Arab person is no superior to a non-Arab person. A non-Arab is no superior to an Arab. A white person is no superior to a black person. A black person is no superior to a white person. We are children of Adam, and Adam was made from dust. That's what Sharia law preaches. So when you saw up there on the slides that Muslims were making institutions of higher learning, they were practicing the Sharia law. When Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, when he moved from Makkah to Medina, and he gave the Jewish people up there the autonomy, they could have the freedom to practice their faith and have the synagogues, and they could have their culture. He gave them the autonomy, the freedom. He was practicing the Sharia law. When Muslims, when they pulled out the Jews from getting oppressed by certain people, as it says in the JewishChronicle.com, it says up there that Muslims helped the Jewish people from getting extinct 2 times in history. Muslims were practicing the Sharia law when they helped the Jewish cousins. So anything which you see up there, which is there from the Quran, from the example of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, that is benefiting the society, benefited the society, helping the neighbors, taking care of the poor, the needy, the homeless, all of these are part of the Sharia law. What is not part of the Sharia law is very important. If anyone is forcefully converting someone and saying that this is part of the Sharia law, actually they are going against the Sharia law. The Quran chapter 2, verse number 256, that there is no compulsion in faith. Means a person could have a freedom of choice what they want to believe in. But if someone is forcefully converting in the name of the Sharia law, they are going against the Sharia law. If someone is oppressing the women, saying that this is part of the Sharia law, no, that is culture. Here is the gold standard. This is what Islam teaches. If somebody is oppressing the minorities, doesn't matter, in Iraq and different places, they are going against the Sharia law. So in a nutshell, Sharia law came as a guidance for individual and for humanity, so we could worship the Creator and we can form societies based upon justice and equality for all, and that is the Sharia law. If anyone disagrees, those people out there, they're actually going against the clear-cut teachings of the Sharia law. That's what it means. Yes. Thank you.